You're watching Minity Maths. In this video we are going to look at how to solve the number patterns from our previous video, linked above. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. Let's look at how to solve this first number pattern. We are given the sequence 2, 4, 8, 16, and 32. To work out the next number in the pattern, we need to look at the relationship between the numbers, also called terms. So, what can be done to the first term, the number 2, to get the second term, number 4? We should generally check for addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. We could add 2 to the number 2 to get 4. We can also multiply it by 2, as 4 is the double of 2. Let's check the relationship between 4 and 8, to see if any of these relationships are still true. Well, we can see that if we add 2 to 4, we get 6. So, this assumption can't be correct. However, if we double 4, we get 8. This suggests that this is the correct relationship for this pattern. We can now check if this works for the rest of the numbers. Therefore, the rule for this number pattern is to double the previous term in the sequence. So, the next term is obtained by multiplying 32 by 2, giving us 64. The second number sequence is 1, 1, 2, 3, 5 and 8. Let's see if we can find a term-to-term rule for this sequence. Notice there is no difference between the first two terms, as they are both the number 1. Let's instead move on to the next term. To obtain the number 2, from 1, we can either add 1, or multiply by 2. However, that would not explain the relationship between the first two terms. So we will go through each term and note down the differences between the terms. Do you notice anything here? Well, the differences between the terms match the original pattern. So, each term in the sequence is the sum of the two previous terms. This is known as the Fibonacci sequence. Therefore, the next number in the sequence is 13. For this next sequence, we are asked to find a missing term from within the sequence, the fifth term. Let's start with looking at the possible relationship between the first two terms. We can either multiply 3 by 2, in order to get 6. Or we could add 3. Looking at this term, we can see that by multiplying by 2, we cannot get 9. So, we can disregard this assumed relationship. However, we can see that if we add 3, we do get 9. Let's check this works for the next term. If we assume this term-to-term rule is correct, then the missing number in the sequence is 15. Now let's check that the following terms in the sequence also fit with this rule. Therefore, we know that each term can be obtained by adding 3 to the previous term. This last number sequence is slightly trickier. At first glance, there is no obvious pattern. If we look at the differences between the first two terms, 2 and 12, we can either multiply by 6. Or add 10. However, these assumed rules do not work with the subsequent terms. We therefore need to look at the pattern in a different way. Let's again try noting down the differences between the terms. Thank you. Next, we should look at the differences between these differences we have just noted down. Do you notice anything here? Well, the differences are actually increasing by 8 each time. We can therefore add 8 to this difference, giving us 42. So if we add 42 to 90, we get 132, the missing number in the sequence. So, the term-to-term rule for this number pattern is that the difference between the terms increases by 8 each time. Thanks for watching Minity Maths. Subscribe, like and comment down below.